हाय गाइस, आज के इस सेशन में हम लोग दो रिएक्शन स्टडी करेंगे। एक रिएक्शन हमारा होगा एडिशन रिएक्शंस और एक होगा हमारा होगा दूसरा होगा रीअरेंजमेंट रिएक्शंस। इसके पिछले वाले सेशंस में जीओसी के अंतर्गत अंडर जीओसी वी हैव सीन देयर टू रिएक्शंस। वन वाज द सब्स्टिट्यूशन रिएक्शंस विद डिफरेंट टाइप ऑफ एग्जांपल्स एंड एलिमिनेशन रिएक्शंस विद डिफरेंट टाइप ऑफ एग्जांपल्स एंड केसेस। Let us see what is addition reactions and what are their examples. What is addition reaction? These reactions actually in which what happens, the attacking reagent, it will add up to the substrate molecule, means the reagent will add with the substrate molecules without any eliminations. And this substrate molecules must have double bond or triple bond. Means if substrate molecule have double bond, triple bond, addition reaction will take place. And with this, one important phenomenon happens: hybridization also changes from sp2 sp3, means and sp2 sp2. So let us see how this whole phenomena happens during the addition reactions. Now this is one example of substrate molecules, and here you can clearly see this carbon is sp2 hybridized and this carbon is also sp2 hybridized, and this is any reagent. So when the reagent will attack on this carbon, the carbon hybridization of this carbon will convert into sp3. Similarly, this is the another substrate molecules, and when the reagent will attack on this carbon, already this carbon is sp hybridized and it will convert into sp. So the, both the carbon is sp3 sp3. So sp2 is converted to sp3 and sp is converted to sp2. So if you are taking if the reagent is attacking only one time, then it will convert to sp2 sp2. Like this one, so let me show you. Suppose it may possible, so you will get this carbon double bond, this carbon, and here is there. So one bond here and one bond is here. So this carbon is sp2. Again, this reagent will attack on this carbon, so this will convert into sp3. So sp2 sp2 and sp3 sp2 is convert to sp3. In this way, hybridization is changes from the substrate to product. Now we'll see what are the different types of addition reactions. So the type of addition reactions is, one is free radical reactions, second is nucleophilic addition reactions, third is electrophilic addition reactions. So we have free radical, nucleophilic and electrophilic addition reactions. So we'll see here only examples, remaining we'll study the mechanism during the when I will give the full syllabus topic then. What is free radical addition reaction? So in free radical addition reactions, this is substrate molecules and this is a reagent. And this is the organic peroxide is some other substances which help in converting into this reagent into adding this reagent into the substrate molecules. So what is the function of this organic peroxide? So they will convert this reagent into free radicals. Free radicals means hydrogen have one electrons and Br have one electrons, and this will be add up on this pi bonds and you will get this product. So you can see this product is CH2 CH2 Br and H. So we can we use a reagent HF HCl. So HCl, so we can use HF HCl, but what happens, their bond energy is very, very high, which is very difficult to break, while the in case of HBr the bond energy is weak, or in HI it is also weak. But in case of HI, problem is that iodine itself is very, very weak, so it will form a iodine molecule. So only HBr is suitable reagent for the addition of free radical addition in the this one alkene molecule or alkyne molecule. So selection of reagent is also very, very important while the taking this addition reaction. So it is very important. So we'll know this reaction one by one. Let's take this example, HBr. When you add it in presence of same organic peroxides, so what will happen? Addition of HBr will take place. So you can see this hydrogen and CH3. So this hydrogen is here, this is the one hydrogen and this is CH3. So after addition, one hydrogen, this H. So this H or Br, this H is added here and this Br is added this side. So you can see the Br is towards you and hydrogen away from you. So when this type of addition will take place, this is called as anti-addition, right? We addition also happens in the same side, like bromine is same side, but methyl is away from the our eyes. So hydrogen will be in front of your eyes. So it is your seen addition. Means you will get from this product two type of addition. One is anti-addition, second is seen addition. So we have two type of chemistry. One is regiochemistry. When you're getting two different products, syn and anti, then this is called as regiochemistry. But in syn product, you are getting the दिस इज अ डिफरेंट ओरिएंटेशन, डिफरेंट ओरिएंटेशन, वन इज डिफरेंट प्रोडक्ट, वन इज डिफरेंट ओरिएंटेशन, वन इज मीन इधर यू कैन गेट अ सेम, तो इस इज कॉल्ड अ स्टीरियो केमिस्ट्री. सो दिस इज योर स्टीरियो केमिस्ट्री एंड दिस टू इज योर रेजियो केमिस्ट्री. Now our next reaction is nucleophilic addition reactions. It is another type of again nucleophilic reactions. What will happen here? Now we can see this is our acetone molecules, okay, and this is a reagent, and this take place under medium BH 9 to 10. This is your again basic medium. So in this basic medium, this will HCl will undergo addition. Why it is called nucleophilic? Because CN is nucleophile and hydrogen is your electrophile. So this will add up along the oxygen. So OH is OH and CN is this side. So hydrogen will have lone pair. Lone pair will take hydrogen and CN will take on the electrophilic carbon. So it will form a cyanohydrin. Similarly, there are other type of addition reactions. So in this case, sodium bisulfide. So it will add it like this one. So oxygen will take sodium and it will get SO3. And again, proton transfer, hydrogen will go this side and it becomes with SO3, it becomes a salt. So it is a bisulfide addition product. Next, if you use the RMGX, which is called as Grignard in ether, so again addition of Grignard take place on ketone products, you will get OMGX and R. So R is your nucleophile, MGX electrophile. So O will take the so this pi electron will come this side. So MGX is taken by the O and R is taken by the R. So you will get the addition product. Similarly, ketone plus NH2Z. Okay, so in this case, what will happen? So from here NHZ, so here one proton is taken by the oxygen, so this will come this side, one proton from NH2Z, hydrogen will come here and remaining NHZ will be added to this electrophilic carbon. So in this way you will get the addition products. I hope you will have understood what is the meaning of nucleophilic addition reactions. Now let us see the electrophilic addition reaction. What is electrophilic addition reaction? So under this electrophilic addition reactions, so electrophile is added in the substrate molecule. So this is alkene and this is Br2. Br2 this whole reaction take me in solvent CCl4. So what will happen? This Br2 is again added in this two carbon like this one, Br and Br. So this you will get as a addition product. Next is CH3CN, and here water is added in presence of acid. In presence of acid and H2 hydrogen peroxide. So what will happen here? Water is added. So H plus OH minus. So OH minus will be attacked here and H plus will be taken by the nitrogen. So we'll get this product. And finally, after tautomerization, hydrogen will shift here and you will get CH3CONH2. Again, if you give again water, so this water will be added in both the side of carbon. So we'll get the two hydroxyl ion. And you know this carbon, when a carbon having a two gem diol, this gem hydroxy, so it will give you water and you will get the finally CH3CONH2 product. So like is there. So this is your again example of your addition of water in CH3CN. Similarly here HCCH triple bond with HBr, so HBr is added along the this unsaturated carbon, so hydrogen Br, so you will get here finally one HBr, so you will get this product. So sp is converted to sp2, again HBr is added, so you will get here this sp2 carbon is converted into your sp3 carbon. Similarly here we have acetylene, in this hydrogen is added in presence of nickel, so this will convert into alkene. Again this two hydrogen will convert to this two separate carbon, so you will get here ethane molecule. So this is again example of addition reactions. Now our next reaction is rearrangement reaction. What is rearrangement reaction? In this reaction, what is happening which involves the migration of an atom or group. So here either atom is migrating or group is migrating from one side to another side within the molecule. In the same molecules, there is a migration of either atoms or the group, and when they will migrate, what will happen? You will get the new molecule formula. So we can say the new compound, actually it is the structural isomers of the original one. So this is called as the rearrangement reaction. Let us see through some examples to understand the meaning of rearrangement reactions. So here I have selected some examples for rearrangement reactions. So we are not going to deal with the mechanisms. Mechanism we'll see during the course of study. N-butane in presence of anhydrous aluminium hydride, so we'll get product isobutane. So we can see the formula is same, but structure is different. Similarly, here this is, you can see butene. So butene is reacting with the aluminium chloride or aluminium sulfate, and strong heating you will get these two products. So again, these three are structural isomers. Similarly, we can see here CH3, and this is your ammonium cyanate. On heating, it becomes your urea. So again, we know that urea is the first organic compound. So these are the rearrangement reactions. Again, this, you can see this example is CH3. So another example is this compound, substrate molecule in presence of anhydrous AlCl3. So you will get here this CH3CO is attacking ortho and para position, like ortho hydroxy acetone and para hydroxy acetone. So these two are, again you can see the rearrangement reactions or structural isomers of these products. You can see very clearly. So let us see some examples here. So suppose this is your CH3 Br hydrogen and H2O, and you are reacting in presence of water. So what will happen? So water will react here. So water will replace the bromine, and you will get the product. How will get the product? So this is compound, and here we have CH3, and Br is out with the positive charge, right? And this here is one hydrogen, so there is a hydride shift. So when hydrogen will shift, this positive charge will come this side, okay? And this is your CH3. So again, water will attack here, and you will form this positive charge, and water will attack here this side, and you will get the product. So you will get product OH, and this is CH3. Similarly, HCl. So first pi bond will attack here. So when pi bond will attack by this H plus, so you will get here, this will shift this side. So this becomes your negative, and this becomes your positive. So in positive means the one hydride shift is there. This is negative, so there is a high hydrogen shifting. Hydrogen will shift to this hydrogen. So this tertiary carbon, this carbon becomes your tertiary. This is more stable, and then after that HCl will react. So HCl means Cl will attack here, this side, and H will attack this side. This is negative charge. So you will get finally product is like this one. So this is your Cl, and this will be your hydrogen. Similarly, in case of this H2SO4, so first dehydration will take place. So in H2SO4, what will happen? So suppose in this case, so first it will form the product like this one. So this is the product, and lone pair will take one hydrogen. So this becomes your here you can say OH2 with positive charge, and this will as very good leaving group. This will leave the groups. This becomes your positive like this one. This is the positive, and when this is positive, so there is a methyl shift. This methyl will shift here. After shifting, so you will get the compound like this one. This is one compound, this one compound with not this one, with positive charge here, and then again so here one hydrogen will eliminated, so as a proton. So this come negative charge, and again this will form the product like this one, here, here, and with the double bond. So finally we'll get this product. So this is the rearrangement reaction of all these compounds. So we'll get the several examples of these type of questions in the coming sessions or lectures. Thank you very much.